This is Dr. Ashwini S.G. I'm a senior and chief infertility consultant at Motherhood Hospital, Hebbal. Today I'm going to speak about some rare topic which is not explored much, but at the same time has grabbed the imagination of people around. So this topic would be gene editing. So I'm going to speak about this CRISPR-Cas9 gene editing technology. Now, this CRISPR-Cas is associated with protein 9, which is an endonuclease enzyme which cleaves the DNA material in the body. So now, this is also, that's why it's also called as a biological scissor. Through this gene editing technology, scientists can remove or replace any defective genome, any defective DNA material, and replace it with beneficial ones. So this gene editing technology can be used in any living organisms to replace any defective genes. So this technology can be used in gene editing, as I said already, and also to visualize DNA or to kill any bacteria. With this gene editing technology, a person can become resistant to any kind of genetic disease. Recently, GenIQ, a Chinese scientist, claims that he has created genetically designer baby, where he says that he attempted to create a genetically resistant genes to HIV. So he claims that through IVF, twin girls were born, and he has done gene editing in the embryos where the girls can be resistant to HIV infection. Now this is a major breakthrough, but all these gene editing on human embryos have to be regulated. They just don't come as easy as it looks. Now, there are certain international governing bodies, the scientific bodies, which govern this gene editing thing. With all this breakthrough, gene editing has definitely grabbed the people's imagination because of its ability to create designer babies. And then people started thinking that they can create any kind of designer babies, like tall babies, intelligent babies, and so on and so forth, but which is a far from approach. There is definitely no denying that this CRISPR-Cas gene editing technology would give us a great opportunity to edit the genes and make the babies free of any kind of genetic disease. But it also comes with the baggage, so it is not easy as we think, because we need to regulate what we are doing on human embryos. So here, apart from the regulation, also we need to know how is the long-term follow-up of these kids when they grow up. So we don't know per se what this experiment, the experiment of gene editing, causes on the baby. We need to really long-term follow-up the babies, whether they are normal and whatsoever. And definitely the human genome is strictly a super complex thing. And to comprehend this vast genetic editing and making it inculcate into a human embryo is from a long way. It takes decades for this to come to a normal practice. So, but I would tell that it will be definitely a helpful field in human genetics to have this inculcation in the normal treatment, so that we have a genetically healthy babies. Thank you so much.